tried to talk about one of the women whose life was really transformed by education. This was Elizabeth, or Bessie Hughes. Bessie's grandparents were agricultural labourers. Her grandmother was a washerwoman in rural Herefordshire. But her father, William Hughes, trained as a whitesmith and came to work in Chepstow in the 1880s. And Bessie was born in Tutshill in 1888. She was one of a number of children. She managed to obtain one of three county council scholarships for girls to the grammar school, which is what seems to have changed her life. In 1911, she was actually working as a teacher in the local church school in Chepstow, in Lower Nelson Street. In contrast, her other siblings were working as domestic servants in different parts of Gloucestershire. Bessie continued to work at the school during World War I, and she also volunteered and served over 270 hours at Gwee House as a volunteer. After the war, she continued teaching. She moved from the infant school to the girls' school. And then in 1921, she resigned because she had met Harold Jarvis, whom she married. Harold was originally from Swansea. He was a bank clerk with the Midland Bank. During World War I, he had served with the Royal Army Medical Corps in France as a corporal. In the 1921 census, Harold was living on the old hill in Tutshill, very close to the Hughes family. He and Bessie were married in Beulah Chapel in Welsh Street in 1921. They then moved briefly to Suffolk before coming back to South Wales, where Harold worked first in Cardiff, then in Borth, then in Pontypridd, and finally back in Borth, where he was the bank manager and where he worked for the rest of his career. So Bessie lived in South Wales, and her father and one of her sisters came to live with them in the 1930s. Harold retired in 1956, and he and Bessie moved to Church Village near Pontypridd. Bessie died in 1969, aged 81. Bessie had one son and one daughter, and I managed to get in touch with her granddaughter, Ruth. Ruth had no idea that her grandmother had VAT service and knew nothing about the family's roots in